¿Cómo estamos en este día? Es muy bonito, ¿eh? Que Dios nos bendice, ¿eh? Quiero empezar, como siempre, dándole gracias a Dios. I want to start by giving, thanking God for allowing me to be here, ¿eh? Dale gracias a Dios por estar aquí, porque si no fuera por Dios, nada de esto fuera posible, ¿eh? If it wasn't for God, nada de esto would be possible, ¿eh? Yo quiero dar gracias a Dios. En el nombre de Jesús, Señor, te doy gracias, Señor, por esta palabra que me has dado, Señor. Te pido que tú seas el que nos des este mensaje, Señor. Que me uses como instrumento, Señor, para poder dar este mensaje al pueblo, Señor. Que este mensaje sea de bendición para nosotros, Señor, para poder usarlo, Señor, y poder ser mejores en la vida, Señor. Te pido que nos fortalezcas, Señor, y que quites toda cosa que nos está molestando en este momento, Señor. Que seas tú el que vayas con nosotros siempre, Señor. En el nombre de Jesús, amén. Quise predicar de esto porque I wanted to preach about this because for the last 2 months, los últimos 2 meses he tenido conversaciones con personas y me han contado su vida, de las cosas que han pasado en la vida, y de cómo en su matrimonio y sus relaciones han fracasado por causa del engaño, por causa de maltrato. Y una cosa que se me vino a la mente es, en el principio, en Génesis, capítulo 1, versículo 27, dice la palabra de Dios: y creó Dios al hombre a su imagen, a imagen de Dios lo creó. Varón y hembra los creó. So, desde el principio, Dios creó al hombre y a la mujer, amén. ¿Para qué los creó Dios? ¿Para pelear con la mujer? ¿Para pelear con el hombre? ¿O para amar a la mujer y amar al hombre? Como una pareja. No nos damos cuenta a veces que por causa de una persona que amamos, una persona que nos traiciona, una persona que nos lastima el corazón, es suficiente a veces para destrozar todo tu camino, toda tu vida, todo tu futuro. ¿Acaso de una persona que nosotros le dimos nuestra confianza, una persona que le dimos nuestro amor, nuestro corazón? Pero se nos olvida el punto. ¿Por qué Dios nos creó a nosotros? ¿Por qué Dios nos creó? Dios nos creó para servirle, para alabarle, para amarle, para llevar su mensaje. ¿Cuándo has conocido una persona que ha creado una persona humana? Ni la persona más inteligente del mundo ha podido crear una persona humana. So, Dios nos creó también para mirar el poder que Él tiene de poder hacernos humanos, así como Dios nos hizo a su imagen, amén. Entonces, ¿qué somos nosotros? Si dice que Él nos creó a su imagen, ¿te estamos representando a quién? A Dios. So, cuando Dios une al hombre y a la mujer, para matrimonio, para amarse, para respetarse. Y a veces no lo hacemos. ¿A quién estamos haciendo ver mal aquí? Si Dios nos enseñó a amar. Y la única razón por la que digo esto, porque a veces, cuando uno tiene un pasado, y uno quiere ser mejor, a veces la persona que tienes al lado de ti es la persona que más te ataca. La persona que te hace, te empuja para abajo, que no cree en ti. Y eso crea que depresión a uno. Y ya cuando caes en la depresión, es duro para salirte de allí. Ya cuando uno está en when you're in depression already, it's very hard for you to get out of it. Because depression is very dangerous. La depresión es muy peligrosa. ¿Y cuántas personas hay ahorita en este mundo que por causa de una persona que amaban y que quizás los traicionaron, quizás se fueron con otra mujer, con otro hombre, ya no pueden ser felices? They can't be happy anymore. So we're forgetting about the whole. We're forgetting about God, our whole purpose in His Word. Amen. Y esas conversaciones que tengo con las personas es todo lo que me dicen. I can't be happy anymore. Yo no puedo ser feliz porque alguien me lastimó. You've been through that. I've been through that. Everybody's been through that at once. Amen. You met somebody before in your life where you thought that was the person for you, right? And it didn't turn out that way. It turned out that it wasn't the right person for you. But who's really destroying you, yourself? The person that was with you or yourself? ¿Quién es el que te está realmente lastimando? ¿Tú o la persona que te dejó? Tú, nosotros, porque estamos permitiendo que el enemigo, y si leemos en Génesis, desde el principio de la Biblia, el enemigo ya andaba molestando a Adán y Eva. Porque el enemigo no puede ver una pareja contenta, el enemigo no puede ver una pareja que se ama. He hates that. He hates to see somebody happy. You know why? Because a married couple that is happy and serves the Lord is a threat to the enemy. The enemy likes to see divorces, right? People fighting, people arguing, people hitting each other physically. And he enjoys that. And we got proof since the beginning. I mean, God created the enemy first, right? He created the angel first before us. So how much does the devil hate you? To know that now we're God's creation and we took pretty much his place, amen? Because God loves us, right? Y otra cosa, another thing that is very important is if you're not happy with your wife or husband and you're not supporting what he's doing, because we're not perfect, amen? No somos perfectos. Sometimes I might make a lot of mistakes, but I don't have my wife telling me, hey, you're not good. Eres un hipócrita. Al contrario, ella me ayuda, ella me apoya. ¿Y cuántas veces decimos cosas de nuestro marido, de nuestra mujer, a personas? Y esas personas quizás te conocen a ti y a mí. And it's like a circle, right? You spread the word and then it goes around. And somehow they're going to find out about what you said. Now you as a husband or wife, how will you feel knowing that somebody's talking behind your back, saying that you're not good for the Lord? ¿Cómo te vas a sentir cuando la persona que tú más amas se entera, se queda diciendo que eres un hipócrita, que anda diciendo que no amas al Señor, que nomás vienes aquí a la iglesia y te das golpes en el pecho, que te paras allí y cantas y que no lo haces, no cantas para Dios, que te crees mucho, que eres vanidoso? How many people say that you're no good, that you come to church and you're a two-faced, that when you come here you show off, you think you're all that, you sing, you preach, but on the street you're a different person? I mean, what kind of wife or husband can say that about the person they love? Is that true love? Again, God created man and woman. He didn't just create a man. He created a man and a woman to be together so that they can help each other. They can support each other through good, bad, hard times. We can't just give up whenever we make a mistake. We're only human. We're going to make mistakes. I know people that say, man, I think it's better for me to be single because I don't want to deal with all that stuff. But at the same time, it's not good to be alone either. You need somebody in your life. Tú necesitas alguien en tu vida. No puedes decir que es mejor estar soltera o soltero porque no tienes que batallar con nada de eso. Hey, nobody said life is easy. We whether you're single or you're married, you're still going through the same thing. The devil's still going to tempt you. The devil's still going to try to play with your mind. And it's sad. It's sad when I hear those things, because I hear those things. Because, you know, in this little town right here, everybody knows everybody. Everybody knows you. Even if you live like 100, 200 miles away, they still know who you are. See, my sister lives pretty far, but they still know her over here, right? And people know you. People know exactly what you do, where you go, everything that you do out of church. And yeah, they can talk. We don't have to pay attention to what they say. But what I'm saying is, when it comes from the person that lives under your roof, when it comes from the same people that are close to you, that's what hurts. Not the people that don't know you or they think they know you. But the people that you have close to you, that you think they love you and you love, and then they go and say you're no good.
Yeah.
So how are we being good Christians? How are we doing what God wants us to do? If God created us for a reason. To see it. And whose fault was it? The devil's fault came, right? He came and he told Adam and Eve, hey, eat from this tree. So he's a liar. He's lying to us.
Yeah.
You are good. And you are strong. And you are going to fulfill what God wants you to do. But we need to stop paying attention to that little voice that is telling us we're no good. Mm-hmm. Makes sense, right? Because who are the people that wants to see us fail? Just because people don't want to come to church, because people don't want to commit to do something for the Lord, then they need to stop spreading rumors about the people that want to make a change.
Yeah.
Tenemos que apreciar lo que tenemos. Y no debemos de poner atención a la gente que dice cosas de ti que no quieren nada con Dios. Si ellos no quieren nada con Dios, está bien. Pero que te dejen en paz. Si tú quieres algo con Dios, si tú quieres hacer un cambio en tu vida para Dios, entonces esa es tu decisión. Nadie tiene que opinar en eso, solamente tú. Nobody has to have an opinion of us, only ourselves, about ourselves. Right? Because people can say whatever they want. People can say, hey, well, I met you before and I know everything you used to do. So you're fake. Okay, that's what you think. I'm glad you think that about me, but I don't.
Yeah.
Because if I listen to that, then that becomes a problem, isn't it? Because once that gets in your head, then you're going to start doing out things just to please people. Because you don't want them to talk about you, right? Another thing I'm going to say, if God blessed you with a good wife and husband, or boyfriend and girlfriend, or right, then you have to take care of that. Take care of them, appreciate them, love them. Not only once a week, on a daily basis, right? If God gave you children, we have to love our children too. And we have to be a good example to our children. That everything that we do, they're watching. You know, I see my son, and sometimes I get mad. But then I feel bad, and I apologize to him. Because I don't want him to see his dad being angry for something that has no value. Because that's what we do sometimes, right? We get mad over the things that don't even matter. If I'm tired, or you're tired, okay, go to sleep, rest. Right? But sometimes we take it out of the people we love. I'm speaking to myself. I'm not speaking to nobody else. I mean, it's kind of sad right now, right? When you look at our church and know that when God created us to serve Him, we take it for granted because we're not here. You know, when I came here today last week, I didn't come last week, yeah.
We didn't serve,
but the week before, I was very sick. And you notice, Pastor said, there were some people that came over, right? And we were not here. And you know, that makes me think, every time somebody comes, somebody new, something happens, you notice that? Either I get sick or I'm too tired or I don't make it to church, but and now it's clicking, it's making sense now. It's the enemy that don't want me to be here when those people come. Because like Pastor said, if we were here, it would have been different, right?
Yeah.
El pastor dijo que hace como dos, tres semanas vinieron unas personas nuevas y no venimos a la iglesia. Y me estaba poniendo a pensar que cada vez que una persona nueva viene a la iglesia, algo pasa, que no podemos venir. Esa es la voz del enemigo que está diciendo, no puedes, estás enfermo, no puedes ir. ¿Por qué? Porque el enemigo sabe que si nosotros venimos, podemos bendecir a esas personas. Y de un modo a otro no podemos venir a veces, porque algo pasa. Y ese es el enemigo que está permitiendo que algo pase. Amén. So everything that happens in our life, the enemy is behind us sometimes. Yeah, I should have showed up, right? I could have played the guitar. And maybe my mom would sing. Or maybe all of us would sing together, right? See, we can do things different. But we don't take the purpose of God seriously. Just because He created us and we're here, okay. Can you imagine if God would have never created us? But He created us for a reason.
Yeah.
We need to acknowledge that.
Yeah.
Why did He create us? We need to ask ourselves that question when we get out of here today.
Mm-hmm.
What can I do different? If God created me, and now I have my other person, my partner, my wife, next to me, then we have to make the best of it. I gotta love her, I have to respect her. And if we get mad at each other one day, hey, we have to get over it. We have to pray so that we can accomplish what God put me and her here to do. Amen? And the only way we're gonna do it is to what? To stick together. Like since the beginning, right? I don't want men to be alone, so I'm gonna create somebody for. Now that I have that person, now that you have that person next to you, hold on to her. Hold on to her. Love her, respect her, love her. Amen. It goes both ways.
Yeah.
I can love my wife very much every day, but it's got to go both ways.
Yeah.
Your boyfriend can love you every single day very much, but you also have to think about how he's feeling. How is your boyfriend feeling? Is he feeling happy? So you gotta do your part. She's like he's doing his part. So my mom, su esposo, tristemente yo se lo llevó. Pero ella pasó por mucho. Ella peleó, ella peleó por ir a la iglesia. Pero ella siempre se mantuvo en la iglesia. Y nunca se dio conocida. Lo que pasó después es que yo lo tocó a ella, ¿no? Y él pudo cambiar, ¿verdad? ¿Por qué? Porque ella hizo lo que la Biblia dice. Se juntó con su esposo y se quedó con su esposo, así como Dios lo mandó. No fue fácil para ella. Pero sufrió mucho. Nosotros somos testigos de todo lo que sufrió. De cuántas veces le gritó, cuántas veces le dijo, ¿a dónde vas? Están locos allá. Pero ella se mantuvo fiel a Dios. Así como la palabra dice, hombre y hembra los juntó. Y gracias a Dios que al último mes se bautizó.
Eso fue la recompensa.
Se bautizó y gracias a Dios quizás él está esperando conocer al juicio. ¿Eh? So, these are examples that we have. Son ejemplos que tenemos en la vida. As we were younger, this is the example we need to follow. Amen. So let's focus on what our purpose is. God wants to do. Que es el propósito que Dios tiene para nosotros. Vamos a enfocarnos en eso. Because we're not done, right? We're not done. We still go. We still continue, right? So we need to focus on what God wants to do. He created us. Remember that. He created us. And everything that we do is going to reflect on Him. Amen. Todo lo que hagamos es una reflexión a Él. If you think He didn't create you good enough, we're lying to ourselves.
Wow.
Because He created you in His image. Which means you, in His eyes, were created perfect for Him. Some of us might have certain things we're going to like about ourselves, but hey, that's the way God created me. You gotta love that about me, right? You gotta love that about you. But why did God create that person rich? Hey, I don't know. God created me unique, like you, right? Dios te hizo a ti único y diferente a mí, ¿verdad? Pero en sus ojos de Dios te hizo a ti como Él quería hacerte. Si a ti te hizo pobre y a alguien rico, está bien. Eso ya no está en nosotros, está. Dios lo permitió así, ¿verdad? What we can do is just make the best of it. Amen? So today when we go home, and if you have somebody in your life, go ahead and tell them, hey, I love you. I respect you. And I'm glad you're part of my life. And I'm glad you're part of my life right now. Because we are the people that they see each other. And we trust each other and we love each other, right? And this is the kind of people right here that we have, is that we need to help each other.
Yeah.
Right? I don't want to hear from somebody that one of my brothers and sisters hate each other because they're always talking bad about each other.
Yeah.
I wouldn't like to hear that, right? I want to hear the opposite. You know, and I'm going to tell Brother Brian right here, man, I respect this man right here.
Yeah.
I respect this man right here because he's always here on Sundays. And he might not understand what we say in Spanish sometimes. He might not even understand what we're saying sometimes. But this man is faithful to God. He's here. You see? And he doesn't even understand the language sometimes. He might understand one, two words. Can you imagine going to a place where you don't even know what they're saying? I would understand him if he would say, oh, I don't want to go to the Spanish one because I don't understand anything. Now, us that speak Spanish should be here, right? But see, he's doing what God told him to do. God created him and he says, okay, this is what I want you to do, my son. And he's doing that.
Yeah.
Right? And hermano Brian, él no tiene ni una palabra de español a veces, como dice el pastor. Pero él está aquí, fiel. Amén. Comprendiendo su mamá. Es una cosa que se debe respetar, amén. Pero let's remember this, okay? What did God create you for?
Come on.
That's something we need to answer ourselves. And don't let somebody else tell you your future either. And don't tell somebody else you're not good enough either.
Come on.
Amen. It's you that need to tell yourself who you are and where you're going. Amen. Nobody else matters. And remember, if God put somebody in your life, hold on to that person. Okay? God bless you all and love you in Jesus' name.